Hello and welcome new and returning viewers, my name is Sauce, and today we'll be taking a more in-depth look at Onryoki. He's a boss that's appeared quite on a few occasions now in our adventure in Nioh. As per usual, start off by talking about abilities, followed by our recommended gear choices and strategies. And without further ado, let's get started. So first off, as per usual, start by talking about this boss's abilities, and to be frank, he only has a few basic moves, but his health pool is so intimidating, it can be kind of a difficult fight. One of the biggest things to mention about this fight is once you've actually dropped him roughly 10%, so where his health is at about the 90% HP mark, you'll actually have this extra NPC come in and help you. He's gonna work as basically your tank for this fight. Now, if he does go down, you can revive him by running up to him and holding circle. However, in order to do this, I would highly recommend if he goes down, kite the large enemy that you're fighting far, far, far away from said NPC. That way you have plenty of time to pick him up and you don't get hit in the process, like you see me do here. Now, as you can see, he's quite clearly right on my tail as he's actually invading the camera as I'm running away. So just as I'm about to pick him up, I actually take a bit of a sidestep. Boom, he hits the ground really hard. He's down for a good second, and then I can safely revive my teammate. No worries whatsoever. Now, back to the boss's abilities. Again, he has a very standard set of abilities. He has his jump attack, he has the large overhand, and he also has a slash combo, which starts off as a single hit, but if it lands one, or you're in proximity for a second or third, he can land up to three hits. So be on guard for this. The number one recommendation that I have for this fight is to just not lock on. As you can see, most of the time I'm just kind of turning the camera and running around. Normally, you're going to roll, or you're going to end up on his underside behind him, which is exactly where you want to be, just by walking towards him. He has such a huge hitbox, you don't really ever have to worry about locking on. So besides that, the next big thing to note is he does have a critical spot, which you see me strike here. Those are the horns on his head. Even once the horns disappear, you can continue to hit his head to build up that additional stagger. And as you see, I just got one shot from full HP. So speaking of HP, let's talk about the next recommendation. If you get hit even a single time, run away, recover to full health right away. This boss has such a high damage output, even for me, where clearly my health is at about 2K, you really don't want to get hit by this guy. If you do, and you can block some of his attacks, but they will dramatically drop your ki. Just, if you get hit, heal. That's your number one, like, oh crap, I gots to go do this right away. And as one last additional note for this boss fight, even though you have the extra NPC kind of tanking for you, at around 50%, the boss is actually going to focus target you. This is going to be kind of your, I need to dash and attack back and forth kind of motion. No matter what, he's just always going to face you at this point. So, you know, you want to roll through his legs, land a quick couple of attacks, and dodge again, like you see here. Alright, so now that we've covered abilities, let's go ahead and talk about quick recommended gear. As per norm for me now, I always recommend the lighter armor tier. This armor set that I'm wearing now, I actually got from Side Mission, where you fight one of the trainers in which you will actually get a Guardian Spirit for, which is what I'm using right now. His entire set is fantastic. You get good key recovery, additional fire output damage, and the Guardian Spirit that he offers is totes nuts. Absolutely beast mode damage, incredible. So highly, highly, highly recommend that. The fire build that I was using seemed to work fairly well on him, so I always try to recommend that, or the wind to have that reduced damage buff on the boss. And that about wraps it up for this video, guys. As always, if you found the content to be useful, please feel free to leave me a like, and always, you know, I'll leave you a little saucy at the very end, that way you know exactly where to click so you can stay up to date with my littlest videos. Mission complete. And again, if you guys have any questions at all, you know, just send me a comment. I'd love to chat with you and talk to you about this excellent game. And until next time, folks, stay saucy.